Some answers can only be found in nature. Discover the unsearchable. Visit discovertheforest.org to find a trail near you. Brought to you by the United States Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Boysenberry more than any ordinary jam. Our citizens for Boysenberry jam fan.
Hi everyone, my name is DJ Honey Bunny Hunky Monkey, and you're listening to WRBB 104.9 FM Boston, a broadcast service of Northeastern University. This is Citizens for Boysenberry Jam, and today we've got a nice little country mix. Well, not necessarily country, although I guess this one is. It's more of a pastoral vibe mix. So, you know, we've got some Bob Dylan, some Woody Guthrie, of course, but then we've got stuff like Peruvian music that kind of sounds like the country, music from Madagascar. We've got a little bit of Brazilian music. We've got Ludwig von Beethoven makes a little appearance at some point. So stick around for that. This one, I'll turn it up a little bit. Spirit on the Water by Bob Dylan. Some of my favorite late period Bob Dylan. This one's from his album Modern Times, 2006. Wait, actually, let me turn it down. There we go. I think it's just this album I listen to a lot as far as late period Bob Dylan goes. It's just that it's really the production that gets me. It's like that, like, it's so good. It's like that faded, like, neon lights, retro style production. Like, obviously the music harkens back a lot to like pre-rock, pre-50s music. That was like his style. I don't think it's like his best late period album. Like, I'm talking about this. A lot of people have been listening to late period Bob Dylan. I'm a big fan of Love and Theft. That's my pick usually. Like, I think it's like his last late period masterpiece, especially with like Mississippi is a really good this is for all the Dylan heads, of course. But I think Spirit on the Water, this one's just a really beautiful song. I'll shut up now and you'll get to hear it. And it sounds like he really does sound like his age. He sounds like he's swinging on the porch with a smile, and he has some really great lines in this one that you haven't really heard because I've been talking. So I will shut up now. Hope you enjoy it.
What does it matter? What price I pay? They brag about your sugar, brag about it all over town. Put some sugar in. On his den. You ever seen a ghost? No, but you have heard of them. I see you there. I'm blinded by the colors I see. I take good care of what belongs. Familiar shrine. I got no
choice. Can't believe these things would ever fade from your mind. I could live forever with you perfectly. You don't ever have to make a fuss over me. From east to west, ever since the world began, I only mean it for the best. I won't be with you any way I can. I've been in a brawl.
I went down to the fishing hole, and I sat down with my fishing pole. Some grabbed my hook, and he got my bait, and he jerked me out in the middle of the lake. Some jumped, I got sunk, baptized on a credit. Fishing down on the muddy bank, I felt a pull and I give a big yank. I hauled out three old rubber boots and a Ford radiator and a Chevrolet coupe. Handed in for national defense. Sitting in a boat with a bucket of beer, and I hadn't caught nothing, but I didn't much care. I guess I was pretty well satisfied. I had my little lady right by my side. Taking it easy, just a-waiting. Worm been gone off that hook for a couple hours. You go fishing, I'll tell you what to do. You go sit down by the greasy slough. Take a piece of string and tie it on your pole and throw it way out in the middle of the hole. Find you a good shade tree and then just sit down and go to sleep. Forget all about it. Jumped in the river and went down deep as a 100-pound catfish laying there asleep. Jumped on his back and rode in him to town. Saddled him up and then I come to town. People come running, looking, dogs are barking, kids are squalling. Stagnate water's a stinking thing, slick on top and all turn green. When I water goes bad, the fish all run. We sat all day and not catch one. It's that mud wallopers, dugars, a few little suckers. I waded out to a sandy bar and I caught myself a big alligator gar. I brung him home across my back. Tail was dragging a mile and a half, flipping and flopping. Sold him for a quarter. Shot crabs, got in jail. Early one morning, it took me a notion to go out a fishing in the middle of the ocean. Throwed out my line, I caught me a shark. I didn't get him home till way past dark. He's a man-eater, tough customer. Just wasn't quite tough enough. Late last night, I had me a dream. I was out fishing in a whiskey stream. Baited my hook with Applejack. Throw out a drink, bring a gallon back. Done pretty good till the creek run dry. So I give my fish back to the finance company.
Hi everyone, that was Talking Fishing Blues by Woody Guthrie, 1944. I've listened to that song so much that I swear half of those like vocal inflections are ingrained in my mind. Obviously, huge influence on Dylan. He had his, you know, he did a couple of talking blues songs in a similar manner on the Freewheelin' Bob Dylan for sure. That one's just a really funny song. I feel like people should just listen to more Woody Guthrie. That's my take for today. Anyway, we are going to be moving on from 1944 to 1808 with a little, since we're doing a little pastoral vibe today, why not go with the Pastoral Symphony, Symphony No. 6 by Ludwig von Beethoven. This is my favorite Beethoven symphony for sure. People definitely gravitate towards the third, the fifth, or the ninth, but I've always been about the sixth. This is the famous, the pastoral, the nature one. Something I find interesting about this one is that my favorite composer is Debussy, and Debussy actually apparently disliked this one, or at least disliked in quotation marks, because, you know, Debussy obviously had the sort of genius cred to just be able to say things like that. He did defend it. I think his issue was with, like, on the grounds of its narrative content. Like, it's explicitly, like, it's put, like, evocative of the countryside. It's, like, program music. The bassoons are there to, like, evoke, like, elk, like, drinking from the water and all that. And, you know, you listen to, like, something like Debussy's La Mer, and then it's just, like, you know, it's not, like, explicitly guiding you on, like, what to feel. It's more like, there's nothing explicitly that sounds like wave splashing or wind or seagulls or anything. It's, like, more about, like, capturing, like, the silhouette or, like, the feeling of the sea. So I get, like, the spiritual differences, but, you know, little old me is still very swooned by this one anyway. So, I will be playing it. This one's, like I said, Symphony No. 6, The Pastoral by Ludwig von Beethoven, and then it's going to segue into The Birds. Hope you enjoy.
leaves are sweetly turning, and the wild mountain thyme blooms across the purple heather. Will you go, lassie, go? If you will not go with me, I will surely find another to go wild mountains high. All across the purple heather, will you go, lassie, go? We'll all go together to bow wild mountains high. All across the purple heather, will you go, lassie, go?
Hi everyone, that was The Byrds, Wild Mountain Thyme, from their album Fifth Dimension from 1966. You know, their take on the old Scottish-Irish folk song. Fifth Dimension is just like, I don't hear a lot of people talk about that album, I guess in the context of 1966. It probably sounded a lot weirder at the time than it probably does now. But Fifth Dimension is like The Byrds' weird psych album, really. Like, it's, you know, has a lot of like weird songs on it, like 8 Miles High. That's still a weird song, like, still, even though that was like a hit. I just think The Byrds are so underrated. I listen to The Byrds all the time, and they're like, you know, they're like a classic band, but they don't have like that like album by album classic status that like a lot of other bands of the time period do. And like, I mean, I don't think albums are necessarily like the best way to like go about like having like canonized albums and like having to listen to like these like big monument canonized albums. You know, if you only do that, then I feel like you're missing out on a lot of like musical context and history. But you, whatever, that's a conversation for another day. You, the person listening, should listen to The Byrds. But not right now, because we're going to listen to some Peruvian music. Both of them Peruvian. We're going to start with an old Peruvian folk song recorded in the 60s. This one is from a local band called Los Hijos de Sangara. This one's called Señor Comandante. It's from a compilation I listened to a while ago called Mountain Music of Peru, Volume 1. Eternal thanks to Simon and Garfunkel for kind of giving me an in to Peruvian music via El Condor Pasa. And then after that, we're going to be listening to some cumbia music from a few years later, 1973, which I'll talk about in a bit, but enjoy.
Thank you. l'arte gira, scrivendo muchacha y la arte gira. Cabe el sargento, carga sus galones, cabe el sargento, carga sus galones, mío pobre soldado, cargando mochila, mío pobre soldado, cargando mochila. Este hermano lechillado. Este es oficial tomando cerveza, este es oficial tomando cerveza, yo pobre soldado tomando agüita, yo pobre soldado tomando agüita. Por culpa esta mata, por mi trabajamos, por culpa esta mata, por mi tatucamos, como soldadito, tu sumita tiene. Como soldadito, tú solo te tienes. Con más ganas, hermano, le he pinchado.
Hi everyone, that was En Mi Pensamiento by Los Beta Cinco, their Peruvian band. That one's from 1973. A little bit of cumbia music. Yeah, I just love Peruvian music. I just remember when I was a kid, I was just absolutely obsessed with the Incan Empire, which was weird. Like, I was like 9 years old, and like I would just like spend my entire day on my computer just like reading articles about the Incan Empire specifically. So like I feel a weird connection to Peru because of that. I can't explain it. It's just very bizarre for a child to be doing, I feel. But my predominant memory of that last song is of my parents and I. We were on a road trip to Tennessee about 2 or 3 years ago. And I guess I like played this song. I don't really remember, but my mom, who was like sitting in the passenger seat next to me, she usually doesn't really comment on what I play, but I do remember she said, she was like, "Oh, this song's really good. Like, it reminds her of the Costa Rican countryside." And I was like, "Okay, that's good enough to put on my little countryside pastoral playlist then." But anyway, we're going to go from 1973 to something a little bit more contemporary, 2013. This one's from a member of the band The Pistol Annies, who you might be familiar with, the country band, three women. But this one's a solo effort from Ashley Monroe. It's from her album Like a Rose, like I said, 2013. This one's titled Used. And I've just been listening to this a lot. I've been listening to Ashley Monroe and Casey Musgraves a lot this last like month or two. It's just the textures in this song are so interesting. They're so good. Like, so much care put into them. You got these, like, it sounds like a tired smile, like pushing through with a tired smile with like those faded electric guitar fills and like the traces of organ, like wispy and ghostly. It's just a really good song. And after that, we're going to, naturally, we're going to segue into some music from Madagascar, which I'll talk about in a little bit. But like I said, this was titled Used by Ashley Monroe. I hope you enjoy it.
Starts to split in two.
Hi everyone, that song was called Patties by Solo Razoff. I got that one from it's this compilation album called The Moon and the Banana Tree, New Music from Madagascar, from 1996, I think. I got to write a little about African music, actually, in the Tastemakers Music Magazine. Shout out Tastemakers. I did write a little, not about this song, but I did write about another song from Madagascar, and I learned a lot in the research of it, for sure. This is a type of music called Malagasy folk music. It's really this polyethnic fusion of, you got Arabic and Polynesian and French influences. Madagascar is a very strange country, ethnically. And the music itself, it sort of forgoes the focus on the groove typical of African music from the mainland in favor of, pure melody. And, that one that I just played is a really good one. The liner notes for the CD, which I'm happy to own, it describes this guy, Solo Razoff, as this guitar magician, which, it sounds right to me. And besides playing guitar, he also plays this bamboo bean shaker instrument called the korinsana. For me, this piece is up there with Leo Kottke's Watermelon. Is just the summer classic, which is, I don't know why I just played it in November. But anyway, we're going to be moving on to all the way back to 1928. I'm going to be playing some Appalachian folk music from a Tennessee fiddle band called the Rowan County Ramblers. This one's called Hometown Blues. I find this one sort of weirdly transcendent, to use a hacky cliche word for it. It sort of becomes this drony, mystical foot stomping thing. If I were feeling particularly silly, I'd almost want to call it a great granddaddy of psychedelic music, even though that's obviously not true. But you don't have to go that far to enjoy some quality old time fiddle music. Hope you enjoy it too. This one's titled Hometown Blues. Thank you.
It's a long way to heaven, a short way to hell. Pain cures won't help when the weight's not yourself. There's poison in the air, personal wealth. It's a long way to heaven, short way to hell. I don't know what I'm breathing for, 'cause the air around here ain't so good anymore. The weatherman sits here, he looks like a lie. Nothing's free in this country, and there's no place to hide.
Everyone, that was Sauget Wind by Uncle Tupelo from 1992, the father band of Son Volt, and more famously Wilco. The song really makes you feel like you're in the Rust Belt. Anyway, the time is 5:55, which means we have just enough time for one more. I'm not going to say too much about this next one, except that this one's titled Can't Find My Way Home, the cover of the classic Blind Faith song by Gilberto Gil, the Brazilian musician. This one's from 1971. All I'm going to say is that it sort of sounds like its title. I'm going to end on a little anxious, troubled note, but I hope you enjoy.
Come down off your throne and leave your bad alone. Somebody must change. so long. Somebody holds the key while I'm near the end and die. Just ain't got the time. Well, I'm wasted and I can't find my way home. Tudo do ba pampeia, arararo papia, vai o papia, vai o papai, vai o papai. Come down off your own and leave your money at home. Somebody must change.
Hi everyone, that's the end of my block. Thank you for listening to Citizens for Boysenberry Jam. I hope you enjoyed today's show. I'll be here every Tuesday at 5, so be sure to set those alarms. And also stay tuned for Botched Mix coming up in just a minute. They're really, really good, and they're here right now, so I'll be leaving now. I'm DJ Honey Bunny Hunky Monkey, and you're listening to WRBB 104.9 FM.